Hi, this is Monika from Vector Garden, and in this very short video I'm going to show how to create a shadow with a gap in between the object and the shadow. So let's dive right in. I've already got the text object here, it's still live, and in order to create several gaps and shadows I'm going to use the Appearance panel, and you can find it in Window Appearance. And in there, I have selected the text object. So not the text, but the text object. You can do that with the selection tool by just clicking on it once. So it needs to read type. And then you create a new fill. And this new fill should be below the characters. So we can use the fill that is already applied to the characters. And I'm going to make this red. And then in order to shift it to the side, we're going to use Effect, Distort and Transform, Transform, and then shift it slightly to the side, just slightly. I'm going to use 0.3 millimeters here, like so, and that's it. And then we're going to use a copy of that, so I'm just going to drag it over here and make the bottom one black, and then let's go into the transform effect and shift it slightly more, like so. So now we have the gap in red and the shadow, the actual shadow, in black. So what we now need to do is punch the gap from the shadow, and I'm doing that by using opacity, setting that to 0, like so, and now it's gone, of course. And in order to get this punched, you go into the bottom opacity setting, like so, and then you select knockout group, and you need to click twice so that this check mark is set. And now it might happen that this doesn't show. Then you have to go into view, preview on CPU, like so. And you see it has gotten slightly better. And this is how you can do that. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.